Hi everyone! Welcome to my channel, Tutorial by Sir Raymond. My name is Mr. Jem Raymond Ischen, Master Teacher 2 from Escalante Central Elementary School, Schools Division of Escalante City, DepEd Region 6, Western Visayas. Click like and share if this video tutorial helps you. Don't forget to click subscribe below to keep updated for my future tutorial. For your suggestions, especially on the topic for my next tutorial, please leave your comment below. Hope you learned something in my video lessons for this week. Thank you so much for watching. Stay home and stay safe. Hello, Grade 6. How are you today? I hope everybody is fine and safe. And welcome to our mathematics class. And this time, it's checking time. Yes, class, we will check your assessment and your additional activities in your Module 1, in your Week 1 for Quarter 3 in mathematics. If you could still remember, last time, I let you answer the assessment for Lesson 1 and Lesson 2 of this module. And we will check this time, what is your score for these two activities? Are you ready? Let us have first your assessment in Lesson 1, in visualizing and describing solid figures. Your assessment could be found on page 13 of the module. Now, please get your piece of paper or your notebook where your assessment is written. Please get it now. Are you ready? Let us now start checking your assessment for, again, this is Lesson 1 of your Module 1 for Mathematics 6. And for the first part of your assessment, you are going to draw the different solid figures, namely the cube, the rectangular prism, the cylinder, the cone, the pyramid, and the sphere. I hope you've done this already. Okay, let's start with the cube. So this is the illustration of the cube. And let's have the rectangular prism. So this is your rectangular prism. Number 3, we have cylinder. And cylinder looks like this. Number 4, cone. Cone looks like this. And your pyramid? So this is an example of a pyramid. And we have sphere. Sphere looks like this. Check your paper there. Next, let's have the part 2 of your assessment. Write T if the statement is true and F if it is false. Let's have number 1. The base of a cone is square. True or false? Of course, based in your illustration earlier, yes, that's false. The base of the cone is circle. Number 2. A cylinder has a circular base. True or false? Yes, that's true. Next. The base of an octagonal pyramid has 7 sides. True or false? Yes, that's false because it has 8 sides. Next, number 4. A pyramid has a triangular face. True or false? That's true. Next, number 5. A cube has 6 faces. True or false? Yes, that's true. Next, number 6. A sphere is a plane figure. True or false? Yes, that's false because sphere is a solid or spatial figure. Number 7. A cone has no vertex. That's false. A cone has a vertex. Number 8. A rectangular pyramid has square faces. That's false because the faces are in triangle. The faces are in a triangle shape. Number 9. A spatial figures are three-dimensional figures. True or false? Yes, spatial or solid figures are three-dimensional figures. Number 10. The faces of a prism are triangles. That's false. What's your score for this assessment? I'm sure you've got a very good score on this part. Let's proceed to the additional activities of your lesson 1 still in module 1. Again, please get your notebook or your piece of paper where your additional activities are written. Please get it now. Okay. Let's answer your additional activities for lesson 1. Complete the table. Write your answer in your answer sheet. Number 1, you are going to draw the figure and then you describe the figure. Number 1, rectangular prism. Rectangular prism looks like this. So rectangular prism is composed of 2 rectangular bases and 4 rectangular lateral faces. So that is how you describe rectangular prism. Next, number 2, rectangular pyramid. This is the illustration of the rectangular pyramid. And rectangular pyramid is a 3-dimensional figure with rectangular for a base and triangular face corresponding to each side of the base. And now for number 3, cylinder. And this is the illustration for the cylinder. So how to describe cylinder? Cylinder has 2 congruent circular bases. Number 4, cone. Cone looks like this. And cone has 1 circular base. Number 5, sphere. The sphere illustration is shown in here. And then it is a solid figure whose set of points are equidistant from the center. Cube. Cube, it is a prism with square base. All its faces are square. And that's all about your additional activities for your lesson 1 for your module 1. And let's proceed now to your lesson 2 assessment. And let us now proceed to your assessment for your lesson 2 still in your module 1. And this is about differentiating the solid figures from the plane figures and identifying the faces of solid figures. And this could be found on page 24. I hope you still have the copy of your assessment in your week 1 module, particularly in your lesson 2. Please get it now. Okay, for your assessment in your lesson 2, the first part is match the solid figure in column A with the corresponding next in column B. Write the letter of the correct answer in a separate sheet of paper. So we are going to match column A to column B. Let's have number 1, cube. It's letter B. This is the net of the cube. When you fold these nets, this will form like this one, a cube. Next, number 2, cylinder. Cylinder is letter E. And this is the net of your cylinder. And this net will form this one, a cylinder. Next, number 3, square pyramid. Where is the square pyramid there? So that's letter C. So this will form a square pyramid. Next is number 4, cone. Where is the net of the cone in column B? Yes, that's letter A. This is the net of the cone and this will form this one. Next, number 5, rectangular prism. Where is the rectangular prism in column B? Yes, that's letter D. This is the net of rectangular prism. And this will form this one. Next. So for letter B, for part B, fill in the blank. Choose your answer inside the box. Okay? So we will choose our answer inside the box. Huh? So number 1, what do you think is the answer for number 1? Blank are flat 2-dimensional figures. What's this? Yes, this is plain figures. Very good. With blank and blank. Your answers there can be interchanged for number 2 and number 3. So, plain figures are flat two-dimensional figures with, of course, that's length and width. Again, as I said, your answer could be interchanged here for number 2 and number 3. These are closed figures which points lie on the same surface. Blank, blank, circle, triangle, and pentagon are examples of plain figures. Your answers here can be interchanged. Now, your answers from number 4 and number 5 can be interchanged. Number 4 is the square and the rectangle, circle, triangle, pentagon are examples of plain figures. Number 6, blank are geometric figures having 3 dimensions. This is solid figure. Blank, blank, and blank. Oh, what are the 3 dimensions of the solid figures? Again, your answers for number 7, number 8, and number 9, and number 9 could be interchanged also. So we have the length, the width, and the height. Next, the cylinder, the prism, blank, cube, cone, and pyramid are common examples of solid figures. What will complete our last statement here? Yes, that's sphere. Okay, again, let us read all together. Go! Plane figures are flat two-dimensional figures with length and width. These are closed figures which points lie on the same surface. Square, rectangle, circle, triangle, and pentagon are examples of plane figures. Solid figures are geometric figures having 3 dimensions, length, width, and height. Cylinder, prism, sphere, cube, cone, and pyramid are common examples of solid figures. What's your score, class? Did you get it right? Good job! And now let's proceed to the additional activities of your Lesson 2, still in your Module 1. A boy visited a toy store and he found the following. The instruction is, from the items that he found, identify which are plain figures and solid figures. Write your answer on a separate sheet of paper. I hope you've answered this last time. Okay? So let's answer your additional activity. Let's identify first the plain figures. So we have, can you guess? Yes. Number 1 is the receipt. We have the paper. And we have the card. So these are the plain figures, no, that he found in the toy store. Next, we have the solid figures. So we have the soccer ball. We have the box. Box is a solid figure. We have also dice. And we have the toy blocks. So again, we've already identified from the items given. We've already identified the solid and the plain figures found in the toy store. Did you get it right, class? Very good. And that's all about your assessment and additional activities for your Module 1, Week 1 in your Mathematics 6, Quarter 3. I hope I have given you enough to help you answering your module in Mathematics 6. Now, watch out for my next video lesson. And that is all about your Module 2. And that is for your Week 2 in Mathematics 6, Quarter 3. And that is all about formulating the rule in finding the nth term using the different figures. Actually, we will be discussing 2 lessons for this module, and that will be released next week. So watch out for that. If you want to keep updated in all my video lessons and in all my video tutorials, please do subscribe in my YouTube channel, Tutorial by Sir Raymond, or you may search Teacher Jem Raymond Chin. For those who have subscribed already, thank you so much. That's all for this week, class. Thank you so much for participating. Have a blessed week ahead. See you next week. Don't forget to stay home and be safe always.